Yep, tell him your full name.
Hey, man, my full name is C.W. Tom.
You represent from Detroit. You're a King Crusader?
I represent from Detroit. I'm a King Crusader alumni. Two championships, two state championships.
That's right. I was at the state championship.
Yes, two state championships.
So what's up with you and your crew tonight? What y'all getting into?
Me and my crew? Look, I'm a party and host promoter. This is my crew that we come out here turnt and drunk. You feel me?
Okay.
You know what I'm
saying? What's the last event you put on?
Last event, which is last Thursday, we had a party called Leave It in the Summer.
Okay, where was it at?
It was on Detroit West Side.
Oh, it was in the city?
It was in the city. It rocked out.
What was your location in Detroit?
It was on like Finkel area.
Okay. Yep, okay. Yep. So you got you bringing the culture up here. What you think about Goodfellas? You ever been over here before?
This is our first time here. We went in our food. You know, we don't smell nothing, so we trying to see how it's gonna taste for real.
Hey, I'm gonna tell you already, dude. You gonna be all in. What you think about the theme and the decor?
Oh yeah, I like the theme and core.
Yeah.
Faking. You got the hard workers up there. They making sure that customers get what they need to get.
Yeah, you can appreciate that, huh?
Yes. Then we got our YouTube channel going right there.
What's the name of the YouTube channel?
It's NBR. That's my man's H Doc right there. H Doc, come here.
Uh huh.
That's my man. They big on TikTok right now. They got a whole trend starting on TikTok.
We're gonna shout them out real quick.
What's y'all TikTok name and YouTube shit, man? You got HW, we got real SPSU
okay,
right here.
We're going to make sure we get that. And then I'm on SPSEdge, Sports Psychology Solutions, SPSEdge. So talk to me about the life of a promoter. I mean, I'm from Detroit. I've been in East Lansing for a long time. But talk about the ups and downs of being a promoter.
I ain't going to lie. The ups of being a promoter, you meet a lot of people. I ain't going to lie to you.
Uh-huh. You meet a lot of people.
meet a lot of people, like different types of people. Like you meet. It's like just all different types of people.
Uh-huh.
Like, no faking. And then we'll come with hosting. You gotta, how can I put it? You gotta be at the same level as the crowd, no faking. Especially if you're hosting, promoting. Like when I throw parties, I be up there just with my people. Like I be hyped just like them. So I gotta match their energy, but a little bit higher.
What got you in the promotion?
What got me promoted? I just started doing this like last year. I'm not gonna lie.
I threw
a birthday party.
And
it just rocked
it
out.
Was that
like,
deal?
It rocked out. Like it started from the inside of a hall and it went to the main street and rocked out.
Oh, the DPD didn't come shut y'all down?
No. This was last year, 2022.
Okay, so that's the upside. Talk about the downsides of being a promoter.
The downsides of it is like, okay, people start seeing you throwing parties and stuff like that.
Uh-huh.
Not everybody wants to throw you on their flight, wants you to be on their flyers. Sometimes people pay you, sometimes people don't. So the only downfalls of that is when people want to use your face and they don't want to pay you.
So sometimes you'll find out they didn't put you on something you didn't even know about?
Yes, it'd be stuff like that.
Come on, man.
It done been stuff like that. It done been people coming to my parties, getting their own video clips of my party being turned and they name it something else. They wouldn't even tag me. You feel me?
You know,
so the only downfalls of that is not getting credit for what you do.
Now, let me tell you about that. I agree with that. Even in the sports world, like when you have a game or something, I think it's a generational thing when people don't give proper homage, man. So, like, you know, you're supposed to tag people. Why do you think people, like, bypass that sometimes?
I feel like they probably, like, just started doing what they supposed to be doing, so they probably just got trying to get, like, free content to boost their page up. You feel me?
Yeah.
But I wouldn't have a problem with them coming to my parties and getting content as long as they just tag me and my stuff. You feel me?
But it just seemed like a common courtesy as, you know, business people. Like, hey, man, this is what I want to do.
I understand that. I get what you're saying. But it's like when they come to my party, okay, they know me and stuff. They record with the rule. I hop on they video, all type stuff.
Yeah.
But then when it comes to them posting the video, they wouldn't, like, tag me or say who party it was.
They taking your content and running with it.
Yeah.
Right. Now, just as you have people who do that, do you have a lot of people who don't do that and they make sure that they name you?
I got two cameramen specifically.
Okay.
I got Dolo Flicks.
Okay.
And I got Kai Visuals.
Okay. And they hold you down like that.
Yeah,
huh?
And they hold me down. They get my clips. They get face up interviews. All that.
I just really, man, I think it's unfortunate. It's just bad business when people don't just do things on a level just with courtesies and all that kind of stuff, too.
And I just started, so I'm still learning. You feel me?
I get it. So talk about how you meet the crowd or where they at. What does it take to get a party, like, to make a party be successful?
What it take to make a party successful?
Uh-huh.
And this generation, to make a party successful, it gotta be the, I ain't gonna really say the crowd, because it can be a big crowd and it still be a dead party, you feel me?
Uh-huh.
So it's like you gotta have the crowd, you gotta have the music.
Uh-huh.
I think the most important part is two most important parts. You gotta have a DJ turn the crowd up.
Okay.
And you gotta have a host who will go around giving out shots and turning everybody up.
How do you manage, and this is not a Detroit thing, when you talk about people drinking and partying, how do you manage people not getting out of hand and potential violence and things like that?
See, look, going with that, every party I threw, it never been no bad incident or no bad reviews. I be cool with everybody. They all be like, Tone, cool, his party, this and that. So they come, you feel me? So they know, oh yeah, Tone throwing the party, ain't nothing gonna happen. Let's go there.
How do you manage that though? I mean,
I manage that by being cool with everybody, make sure everybody's genuine, love, having fun. Like I literally walk around the whole party through the whole night, make sure everybody okay.
So do you think that's where people end up having issues, because they're not checking on their party goers and managing people? Because
you would never know what's going on during the party, throughout the party, because you probably, that person probably be in one spot throughout the whole party, and you hosting the party, you would never know what's going on. See, me, I'm the host. I'm the type that want to go around, make sure everybody good, everybody got shots, y'all good, y'all want a shot, if you don't take one.
Yeah, that's okay. I love this. So tell me this, because this is some great information. What if you hear about or kind of sense some beef brewing? How do you manage that?
I would go to like, yo, what's going on with the rules? I had one person tell me what's going on. He tell me his side. Then I go to the next person. He tell me his side. I'm like, bro, it ain't even working, bro. It's too many people out here to just try to do some dumb stuff.
So what? And how may they respond to that?
They respond like, Tone, you feel me? I know you. I respect you. This and that. Then they be like, but bro, what's on this and that? I be like, I understand that. You feel me? You all come from the same spot, area. I know how that goes. You gotta ignore that stuff sometimes. You feel me? It ain't worth risking the rest of your life, no matter what you might do after you want to beef with somebody.
So you talk them down with that.
Yeah, you feel
me? Let's flip it to females.
Females.
You got some lovely ladies with you tonight in your crew.
Yeah, I do. Hey, great jacket, right? Yeah.
Okay, all right.
Hey, Diamond. Oh, I don't got it. That's my girl. My bad.
We're gonna let you wrap up so you can deal with family.
What
you just talked about was, and I like that. I like how you represent. We're gonna make sure we get this out here too. Mm-hmm. I like how you talked about how you dealt with men and masculine energy, but how feminine energy can be.
Female wise. Okay, back to that. So it's like usually females don't get into it at our parties. It'd be like only time a female to get into is they like say one of they. Say that female mess with that dude, and that dude be messing with another female, and they both of the females come to the same place at the time.
Uh-huh.
He get caught up, then the female want to act tough. That's the only reason that'll pop out. So,
but just like you kind of diffuse the masculine energy.
The way I diffuse a female problem is like, come on, bro, y'all females, bro. That's not cute. This and that.
Uh-huh.
They still want to get loud, but I know they gonna want to get loud. So I try to get the laugh and the joke, and you feel me?
Uh-huh.
Like, come on, they ain't even worth it. They ain't worried about y'all, this and that. I get to laugh and making jokes, and y'all want a shot, and they take a shot, and we bet to have a
so fun. So it's really that, even though people can get, and this is great information, man, I gotta tell you, you're doing a great job with the information you're sharing. It's really that no matter what, people want to be able to be brought back down. They really don't want to cross the line and go there, but it seems like it happens in so many other scenarios and whatnot that they just don't have that person to bring them down. So what is that, they need attention or something like that?
It's the way you approach them. It's the way you approach them.
But see,
that's really what it be. It's the way you approach somebody. If you, it's like if I came over here aggressive, talking about some, hey, yo, what you, give me a podcast right now. You would have been like, yo, man, chill out. No, you feel me?
Yeah.
You see, I came over like,
see,
hey,
I'm from Detroit too, so that Detroit energy come out, right?
So you feel me? I came over like, hey, can I hop on a podcast? You feel me? You
let
me do it.
Oh, yeah.
So it's really about the approach, how you approach somebody. That's how their energy going to reflect.
Have you always been like that? that and being able to deal with different people and approach people differently?
Yeah, I have. I have.
That's I'm a great skill set. Do you I'm think your size, you're a pretty tall guy.
I'm 6'8".
Yeah, you 6'8".
Yeah.
How does your size play a role in how you approach people?
I ain't gonna lie. The ladies, they love tall dudes. I ain't gonna lie to you.
Yeah,
I'm tall, dark skinned, nice smile, cool person. You feel me? So they gonna mess with me. You feel me?
Yeah.
And I be having all good vibes. So it's like, they just mess
with me. Now, what's the flip side of that? Because that, does that put you in a situation to be intimidating to some people who are insecure sometimes?
No, the only bad side about being a ladies man and having all the females saying you cool and this and that.
They get to hating on you.
It'd be like, say you messing with one female, and she get the feeling some type of way saying you friendly, this, all the that. So that'd be the only downfall about that part, if you mess with somebody. But other than that, if you ain't messing with nobody, and you just out here having fun with the female friends, these is my friends right now. I ain't gonna lie to you. They all my friends. Naya, BB, and Ken.
Uh-huh.
You got Jordy.
Now, I'm a little bit older than you, so from a generational standpoint, I find it interesting that your generation, you guys have a lot of male-female friends.
Mm-hmm.
Now, okay, I'm going to throw this part. Do some people use friends, not saying you do, as a front, or they hit you with, oh, that's my sister. But still, it could be end up something going on, whatever, or not.
Mm-hmm.
Do a lot of guys do that?
A lot of guys do that, but speaking, I'm going to speak for myself on that. I don't do that, because I didn't lost sisters and brothers. So if I say that's my sister or brother, that's real, like, what that is. Like, that's my, with the pink, that's my sister.
Yeah.
People that thought we didn't been on it before, that's literally just my sister. Nothing else. I love her to death.
Yeah.
Like, we literally talk about everything together. No faking.
I think that may just be a generational thing.
Yeah,
that you
it's
guys,
a generation thing for sure.
Yeah, you get that. Well, look, man, you're doing a great job. I'm glad you decided to come over, man. Your crew is representing well. So what's the next thing you got coming up?
The next thing I got coming up, we got an Ultimate Black Party coming up.
Ultimate Black Party. Not just a black party, ultimate black party.
Ultimate black party.
What makes it an ultimate black party?
Last year, this is where everything black, all black.
You got a venue yet?
Yeah, we working on that right now. Last year, we threw an ultimate black party. This year, is about to be a part two of that. Like, everything
where it got. Where was it at last year?
Last year, it was on Puritan, on the west side.
You'll keep it funky on PA, huh?
Yeah, it was on Puritan, yeah.
Okay, well, here's the thing, man. Say your social media so people can make sure they follow you. We can put that up right now.
Follow me on Instagram at cw.tone. I'm a host/promoter. If you need me to host your parties or promote your parties, just hit my DM and I got y'all.
Hey, okay. Well, man, I'm glad you came over, man. We're going to get this out pretty soon and they can keep supporting. I want to wish you the best of luck, all right?
All right, thank you.
All right,
nice
all the best. You too. With that being said, Lindsay Ellison with SPS. We'll see you next time. Peace.
Peace.
How lucky can one guy be? I kissed her and she kissed me. Like the fella once said, ain't that a kick?